This video will guide you through the important considerations when fitting automation to a gate. Safety requirements must always meet the European norms. Full details of these can be found on our website. Electric gate safety can be split into two main categories: vehicle protection by the use of photocell beams or the built-in obstacle detection, and pedestrian safety through the use of safety edges. Vehicle protection. Assuming the gates are opening inwards, photocell safety beams are placed between the gate posts on the outside of the gate and across the drive just beyond the length of the gates on the inside. Their function is to prevent the gates from closing onto a vehicle placed within the swing area of the gates. If a beam is broken before the gate has started, the gate will not move. And if the gates are in their closing cycle and a vehicle breaks the beam, the gates will reopen. It is necessary to use two safety beams on the inside and outside, especially when using the automatic closing feature. If your gate opens to a wide space or courtyard, an induction loop or metal detector can be used to sense the vehicle presence in place of a photocell beam. Photocell safety beams generally only operate during the closing cycle. Obstacle detection. All our gate systems have built-in obstacle detection. When the gate runs against an obstacle during opening or closing, it will sense the pressure change and reverse to a safe position. The obstacle detection generally does not work during the slowdown phase of the opening or closing cycles. Obstacle detection does not replace the need to fit safety edges, as the maximum force requirements of the European norm are set very low. The obstacle detection will reverse the gates after a preset pressure is reached, whereas a safety edge will reverse the gates in less than a quarter of a second at very low pressures. Safety edges. Pedestrian safety is generally covered by fitting safety edges to the danger areas on the gates, the hinge point of the gates if there's a chance of being trapped between the gate and the post, and sometimes horizontally along the gate's wing if there's a chance of being trapped when the gate is opening between the gate and a wall or fence, etc. The gap between the gate and the wall should be a minimum of 500 millimeters. If the gap is less than 500 millimeters, a safety edge must be fitted. As per the current requirements, our control boxes constantly monitor any resistive 8K2 ohm safety edges fitted to the gate. The monitoring is to ensure they're always in working order. If this test fails, the gates will stop. Motor mounting. The motor mounting pivot position is determined using the instructions provided for the motor. The starting point of the A to B measurements is always the center point of the gate hinge pin. The A and the B measurements can be seen in the picture. The A measurement is across and the B measurement is back. For ease of fitting and for professional installation, we would strongly recommend the use of our heavy-duty adjustable bracket set. Thank you for watching. If you have unanswered questions, please call to discuss them. This video is a simple guide to correct and safe installation. Installers should always apply the current necessary norms or UNAC guides in full.